Guys, are you able to listen my voice?
Yes, sir.
All right. So our today's lecture is basically on T-beam design and analysis of T and L beam. Are you able to see my desktop screen?
Yes, sir.
All right. So as the name indicates, the beam which is in the shape of a T or L, that we call as T beam or L beam. Basically, in T beam, the part of slab is acting as a T beam. Now, this part which is actually inside the slab, that we call as flange, and that part which is projected out from there, that we call as web. Similarly, that part we call as flange, and that part which is projected out from the slab, that we call as web. Now, this distance we call as B or effective depth, or BF. D is again distance from centroid of reinforcement to the top fiber. BW is the web thickness or web width. HF is basically thickness of the slab. Sometimes this web we also called as stem. Now, question is, how initially we can assume that effective width or B or BF? If we have T beam, so for T beam, we can choose effective width out of these values. L by 4, 16 HF plus BW, BW plus half clear spacing of beam on both sides. So basically, out of these three formulas, whatever the minimum value is, that we will choose as effective width of the T beam. And if we have L beam, we will use these three formulas, we will get the values, and out of these values, whatever the minimum value is, we will choose as effective width. Now, we have basically three cases for the T beam. In real sense, we have actually two cases. Either we need to design the beam as a T beam, or either we need to design beam as a rectangular beam. Ya to hume rectangular beam design karna padega, ya hume T beam design karna padega. If the flange, this is the flange, or this is the flange, if the flange is in tension, we do not, I am repeating, we do not need to design as a T beam. We need to design as a rectangular beam if the flange is in tension. If the neutral axis, this is neutral axis, if the neutral axis is lying within the flange, this is the flange. If neutral axis lie within the flange, we need to design as a rectangular beam. No need to design as a T beam. Or in other words, C, if C is less than HF, C is distance from neutral axis to the top fiber, and HF is actually thickness of the slab. If C is less than or equal to HF, we need to design as a rectangular beam. Now, when we need to design as a T beam, if neutral axis, this is the neutral axis, if the neutral axis lies outside the flange, this is the flange, this portion is the flange. If neutral axis lies outside the flange, or if neutral axis is basically within the web, or C is greater than HF, then we need to design as a T beam. So only if neutral axis is within the web, we need to design as a T beam. Now, we need to develop a separate equations for the T beam, just like similarly we have done previously. We have T section, then we have strain diagram, Whitney's test block. We can say that the portion which is in the flange, that is represented by CF. The portion which is in the web, that we call as CW. So we have internal compressive force contribution from the flange, internal compression force contribution from the web. We have tension steel reinforcement. So we will just T multiply by this distance, right? We will get basically total moment. We need to write the moment equation if you go that. So moment equation, if we are considering, we know that M is equals to C times LA from previous knowledge. So if we at the end, if we write the equation, we will get 0.85 FC dash B minus BW into beta 1 HF, this and this expression. This is from the compression side if we want to write the moment equation. If we want to write the equation from the tension side, we know that M is also equals to T times LA. So this is the equation. MN, ASF, FY, and this whole. You can use for moment capacity, either you can use that formula or you can use that formula. Either you can use from compression side, either you can use from tension side if you want to calculate the moment capacity or flexural capacity of the T-beam. Similarly, if we want to ensure the tension control, rho W needs to be less than or equal to rho W max, then we can say that this is tension controlled section. If rho is greater than rho W max, either we have transition or compression controlled section. All these formulas, this one and these movement formula, are actually given in your design aid manual as well. Now, as I said, if you want to do capacity analysis, you know the cross-section dimension, you know the area of cross-section, you need to calculate the moment capacity or flexural capacity. So first thing is that you need to see whether you need to design as a T-beam or rectangular beam. If C is less than HF, you need to design as a rectangular beam. But if C is greater than HF, you need to design as a T-beam. Then you need to calculate different parameters, ASF, ASW, ASF, and you need to get the flexural capacity. You guys, is PDF ko ek dafa khud se dekhen, and do let me know if you have question. Is PDF ko ek dafa khud se dekhen. I have uploaded that PDF on MS Team. So kindly watch that from the MS Team and let me know if you have any question. Ek dafa isko khud zara dekhen, please. Guys, have you read the PDF form? Guys, you have read the PDF form? And if you want to ask me any question.
सर एक फॉर्मूला पूछना था।
श्योर जी पूछें।
सर रो वेब और रो फ्लैंज का फॉर्मूला अगर आप 15 स्लाइड पर देखिएगा।
स्लाइड नंबर 15 पे जस्ट वन सेकंड जी। ASF डिवाइडेड बाय BW इनटू D।
सर रो फ्लैंज के नीचे BW है या BF?
आप ये बात कर रहे हैं इसकी?
यस सर।
अच्छा ये जब हम बात करते हैं ना रो की तो नॉर्मली वी आर बेसिकली टॉकिंग अबाउट टेंशन स्टील, ये वाला, ठीक है? हम ये टेंशन स्टील की बात कर रहे होते हैं ना, तो टेंशन स्टील पे जो विड्थ है वो विड्थ बेसिकली बी डब्ल्यू ही है, वो यही है, ठीक है?
यस
जी। मैं फिर भी लेट मी कंफर्म फ्रॉम बुक एज वेल, एक मिनट मैं बुक से भी आपको ये बात कंफर्म कर देता हूँ जी। अगर आप लोग जाएं ना बुक का पेज नंबर 145, ठीक है, 145 पे भी देखें तो वो बेसिकली बी डब्ल्यू ही है, ठीक है?
थैंक यू सर, थैंक यू।
पेज नंबर 145 है बुक का। All right, guys, if you do not have any question, then I am going to end the meeting. So we will meet next time and we will try to solve the examples. Okay, guys, thank you very much and Allah Hafiz.